Kavango Regional Youth Choir, all the way from Kavango East, representing Kavango East and Kavango East.
Basically, the purpose of the choral concert was an exchange program between the Trans Kalahari Youth Choir and the Kavango Regional Youth Choir. This was initiated because the Kavango Youth Choir only started last year, so they were just creating a platform to expose their choir members to what we are doing this side of the country. And also because they only started last year, they were trying to see how have we been doing things for the past 12 years or so, and so that we can also learn from them, you know, with different cultural differences, to learn what they are doing and what we are doing this side in our different choirs. We had a workshop during the day where we were looking at the choir ethics, stage performance, rehearsals, importance of rehearsals, selection of song, and the uniqueness of choir. We're emphasizing in terms of each choir has to be very unique, different from the other choir, because you are from another region. You should not really necessarily try to sound like another choir just because they are more older than you. You have to have your own identity, your own unique sound. And that also helps to sell your choir, because you're doing something different from them. And we're probably also looking at the different techniques that we are using that they can also learn from us and then put in practice. Yeah, and we exchanged quite a number of songs which they are doing and which we're doing. These guys were quite motivated and excited. They were willing to learn, and the fact that the participation, it was very, very high. They were asking a lot of questions, so it was easy for us as facilitators to carry over the message, because you could see that they really understood why they were coming here, and they understood the effort and the money and the resources that went into getting them here. You understand? So it was very easy. What I actually also want to emphasize in is that you could see they learned, because at the end of the day, when we had the concert, you could see that most of the things that we spoke about during the workshop, they could really put it in practice, and one could see a difference, because the Friday when they arrived, they sang a couple of songs. You could pick up on their sound. My kids also did their own couple of songs. And because I also have a couple of new guys, you understand? So this was also a great platform for to expose them also. And also putting the two choirs together, the blending of the two different sounds. It was so awesome that it was overwhelming. I really like it. And these guys, you could see that they were really interested and they really enjoyed it to the fullest. Flash mob is whereby you have your choristers organized in a way that the audience don't really realize what is going on until you are somewhere in the middle of the whole mob, and then they tend to say, oh, this is a choir, oh, this some weird faces, because they did not know the guys from Kavango. They could identify some faces from Trans Kalahari, but then later say, oh, but these are two different groups, but wow, the sound is huge, it's different, but these guys are performing well. When did they practice, you understand? Because they did not see the guys here, but all of a sudden this thing is happening. We did it at ShopRite and also at Spa. And at Spa it was more outside in the street. You could see taxis pulling down, you know, people pulling down, some hootering out of their cars just to see and to acknowledge that they see what we're doing and they appreciate it. The setup of the concert was in a platform that people had to sit, literally sit and listen, because we had combined performances of the mass choir and also the two choir doing their own individual performances. The most outstanding one was the opening song, Nimansus Iyer. It was conducted by Gershon. It was a song that they taught us in that fact. It was beautiful. thing. And then the excitement went up. You know, people just started making noise and enjoying. And that's one thing that we really struggled with when having this type of concert, because people this side are more used to traditional music. Now, when you come to this type of choral music and a bit of classical music, people don't really understand that they need to sit and listen to the song from the first note till the last. But we tended to bring them a little bit down, and you could see the difference that they started appreciating the music in terms of, you could see some of them trying to hear more of the solo parts, because now they also try to understand that besides that you're singing in a choir, you have your own unique voice. So you could see when they were requesting songs to be done over, they wanted to hear more of the solo. So one could see that they understood the concept of the concert at the end, and that's why they wanted more and more. But I believe that with more concerts and with more of these things, the public in general, they're getting more educated in terms of listening to choral music.
Thank you.
For Trans Kalahari Choral, there's a lot of things that we plan to do, but you know that funding is a bit difficult this side of the region. But besides that, we will push. Already two CDs, we're trying to work on the third one and also a DVD. And as fast as the funds come in, we will definitely go for the third CD and also the DVD, because it will be a combination of the songs in the three albums to do the DVD. And we're also planning also to travel to Kavango, because they feel that They need to show their people what they learn from this side and what is different from what they are doing, because their people know that they travel to Gobabis. Now they need to us to go that side so that people on the other side can also see that there's a different styles of music and different cultures and so. So we're also planning to go there in the next 2-3 months, also depending on the regional leadership, how fast they can then assist us, and then we'll be packing our bags and traveling to Kavango.